Welcome back everybody, I got a new tractor. This is a nearly new Kubota M4. I've never had this model. In fact, I haven't even touched this model yet. I haven't laid my hands on it. I'm gonna give you my first impressions coming up. As always, if you enjoy the video, I would love to get a thumbs up from you. Leave a comment down below with your thoughts. Subscribe to see more tractor videos, and if you want something for your machine, make sure you check out goodworkstractors.com. Now I'm telling you the truth, I have yet to touch this tractor. One of my guys, Andy, offloaded this for me, parked it here. I literally have not touched it yet, but we're gonna fix this mirror. So I spent about 50 grand sight unseen. Yeah, it was from a dealer I do a lot of business with. This was a trade-in to him. The gentleman that had this tractor, bought it new, should have never owned it to begin with, right? He bought too big of a tractor for his property. It was one of those things, he should have had like a 2 Series tractor or a Kubota LX. Anyway, it sat. It's got about 50 hours on it. It's a 2020 model. I've had my eye on this Kubota M4 Series. They've got a 61 and a 71 horsepower variant. There's a standard and a deluxe version. This is the deluxe version. I think it's the M4D-071, kind of a long, confusing name. But we're gonna go over it today. I'm gonna tell you why I wanted to get one of these models to try it out. I was ready for a change. I'm selling the John Deere 4720, so look for that soon. But I am not affiliated with John Deere. I'm not affiliated with Kubota. I'm independent, right? So I can get different tractors in, play around with them, try them out, sell them off. So really, I think that's to your advantage because I have no qualms about telling you if I do like something, if I don't like something, just giving you my honest opinion. I'll tell it like it is. Oh, and make sure you stick around later. We're gonna hook up the land plane, do a little driveway grading, and see how it does. All right, so first, what is this tractor? Well, it's a 71 horsepower utility tractor, all right? So I'm used to the compact tractor world. That's the majority of this channel. However, I have some larger acreage out here, and a utility tractor could come in pretty handy. So utility is a step up from the compact world. So you have subcompact, well actually, you have garden tractor, subcompact, compact, utility, ag, and so on. It just keeps getting bigger in classification. So this tractor is only 5 horsepower more than my 4720 or the 4066R, but it's a bigger footprint, okay? So it's heavier, it's bigger dimensionally, it'll lift a little bit higher with the front end loader, more 3-point capacity. It's also gonna be a gear drive transmission versus a hydro. That's gonna be a big difference. Now, every tractor has its place, but what I'm buying this machine for is gonna be for a lot of field maintenance, driveway maintenance, tilling applications, and these are all potential scenarios where a hydro transmission is going to be less efficient or potentially overheat like we saw this summer. So the gear drive is kind of like built-in cruise control. So if you're doing field mowing, like this big field out here, or grading out your driveway where you're just going in one long pass at a steady speed, or even tilling a food plot or a garden, you just put it into gear and you go. It's gonna run at a cooler temperature than a hydro transmission, and it's gonna put more power to the ground. So while this tractor does have a front end loader on it, that is not really gonna be one of the primary uses that I have this machine for. I just didn't want to get one of these tractors without a loader because I will have to use it from time to time. I do have a skid steer over there. I've got my smaller 1025R, which is going to be great for inside the woods. So everything kind of has its place. All right, let's talk about the loader first. You might see LA1154. That's going to be the same loader I think that we saw on the MX6000, maybe even the L6060. So this loader, or at least something similar, is gonna be used on a lot of different series offered by Kubota. So lift capacity isn't necessarily a lot greater. You will see these loaders have a couple different positions. There's a power position, so you can lift more weight. And then there's, I don't know what the other position's called, maybe a height position, so you can lift a little bit taller if you need to. So you'll see this right now has a bale spear on it. I have absolutely no need for this. So if somebody wants this, let me know. We can disassemble it and ship it out to you. It did come with a bucket, but they forgot to send that along. This tractor came from Georgia, so they're gonna have to ship that up to me. It is equipped with the skid steer quick attach as well, so that makes it an easy transition from the bale spear to a bucket, to a grapple, to a snow pusher, to whatever. But speaking of a grapple, that's one thing that is missing on the front end loader. I'm gonna have to add that on as a third function hydraulic set, something with a thumb control so I can control that open and close function of a grapple without having to take my hand off of the joystick. And anytime you see this parking stand up here and then this pin that's back in this area, you're gonna know it's a quick park loader, so you can take the whole loader right off your tractor if you need to. And I want to make sure I give credit where credit is due. Kubota is very good with their loader design on trying to hide their hydraulic hoses and lines as much as possible, run them underneath the loader arms, give good protective covers up front across the torque tube, just hide them whenever they possibly can. They do a really great job. So there's a few things going on in this area kind of working our way up, and the first thing you might notice is this toolbox. I feel like The same location was used on the M7060 that we had a while ago. Seems like kind of an odd location, however. It's the same height as the axle, so I suppose if you've driven over anything and it didn't affect the axle, it shouldn't affect the toolbox, in theory. Tucked right behind there with a little protective plate underneath is going to be your fuel tank. And I do like this easy location. You don't have to reach up high anywhere in order to fill the tank up. And you will see you have a double step. There's actually a whole other double step on the other side with a full door. We had a John Deere 5 Series, a 50-55E. I think it applies to any of the 5 Series as far as I know, or at least a 5E Series. The far side is just a fixed panel, essentially. It looks like you could potentially upgrade it to have a door handle and hinges and everything else, but this actually came equipped with a door on both sides and steps too. Pretty sweet. So you do have a pair of caution lights up here, the flashers, which I think is an okay location. It also looks like they could also get snagged on something and ripped off too, but I guess time will tell there. Of course, you have your grab handle. These mirrors came standard as far as I know, which is really nice, at least on the deluxe version. I don't know if it's the standard version of the M4, if they'll come on there or not. And then you got your antenna. And check this out. For the first time I've ever seen it standard, on a tractor at least, LED lights on the cab and on the headlights too. So you tell me, is that a first? I know you can get them aftermarket. We've replaced a lot of bulbs aftermarket with LEDs, but coming from the factory with LEDs, you tell me. Any others out there? So these are going to be the R1 ag tires, or the farm tires that you would typically see. They're in nearly brand new condition. This tractor only has about 50 hours on it, if I didn't mention it. It did come from down south. This literally just arrived a couple hours ago, and you can see we're a little low on tire pressure there on the front, so we got to add some more PSI in there coming up to the cold weather up here. Now, one thing, I got to verify this still. I believe there's a cast iron center plate option that you can get for the M4. And if so, I don't believe this is it. But that cast iron plate would allow for additional ballast weight on the backside. If these tires aren't loaded, we're going to load them up anyways, and we'll have something hanging off the back, so we'll be okay. But that is a nice option to have. But I swear I saw that option looking up the details on this series here, so trust but verify. All right, taking a look at the backside of this tractor, you're gonna notice a few things going on. First, you are gonna have a pair of remotes not tied into your thumb control. You're gonna have a couple of levers that are up there on the fender, but a fourth and a fifth function is gonna come standard on the deluxe package. You're also gonna have your 7-pin outlet up top. You will see a pair of external cylinders for your 3-point lift, which I believe this will lift over 3,000 pounds, so a lot of weight up there. It's gonna be a category 1/2 3-point hitch, so this ball size is gonna be a cat 2, but you can put sleeves on there, and these telescoping draft links can easily and quickly adjust your 3-point hitch in and out. You can see how narrow you can make that if you needed to, and how wide it can go as well. You can put that pin back in place and lock things back up. But there's also a couple other features that are going to make it easier to hook up to your 3-point hitch. So I believe these are called telescoping draft links, or draft ends, something along those lines. You'll hear these terms, and I use it for these telescoping bars as well. They're used interchangeably, so if they have a specific name that's one or the other, I don't know, maybe you guys can enlighten me. So there's one other cool feature as well, which I highlighted on my John Deere 4066 a couple of years ago. But if I turn this knob right now, which is kind of has these weird brackets around it, I don't know why, but you can see how it's gonna lower down. If I had the tractor on, I could turn that knob the other way and raise it back up. A few other features worth noting are going to be your drawbar that's located down here on the bottom. Of course, you do have your standard 540 RPM rear PTO. You will see your hydraulic oil fill along with a separate dipstick, which are both very easily accessible, so that's well designed. And then you have your fluid reservoir for the washer fluid too. So a couple final thoughts on the outside. Metal all around, metal hood, obviously metal loader and whatnot, but these are going to be plastic fenders that you see back here on both sides, which doesn't bother me at all, but for some of you guys that really despise plastic on the John Deere's, these are plastic, okay? So they are not steel. Also, on a good note, there's a lot of really good guards, protective guards that are on the tie rods, around the hydraulic valves and fittings down here, on the fuel tank on the other side. There is one small area on a couple of hoses that I think they should have done a better job guarding, but that's kind of nitpicking. I think overall they did a really great job. Taking a quick peek underneath the hood, good access for the battery, which is important because we had to jump it. It was dead when we went to get it off the trailer earlier. Had to jump it to get it off. I don't know if that was something to do with not being used to the cold weather that we have up north right now or not, but it's a pretty full engine compartment. They're not wasting much space underneath there. Looks like we got to clean off the radiator screen a little bit as well. Easy access to the engine air filter as well, but overall, pretty typical looking engine compartment. The one thing I can't figure out on the outside is this little widget thing here. I have no idea what that's for. Clear plastic tube going inside. I just figured it out. Washer fluid spray, that's what it's for. Mystery solved. All right, I wanna get started on the interior, but really quick, a small correction. I was looking up a couple of specs and I saw this is actually 73 horsepower, even though it's a 71 model. I don't know what that's about. I mean, it'd be a lot easier if they just said 73 and it was 73 horsepower, or 71 and it was 71 horsepower. Neither here nor there, 73 horsepower, which means it has about 60 horsepower at the PTO. All right, this is my first time sitting in one of these tractors, but I'll tell you, one of the great things, one of the great reasons I wanted to get this one in particular is it's got the jump seat, or the little buddy seat here, so I can take my kids along with me, or maybe my brother too if he wants to bum a ride somewhere. But this is one of the reasons I didn't want to keep the M7060 that I had previously. This just had a few upgrades that I really liked, such as this, and a couple refinements in here that I saw online. But it even has a horn right in the steering wheel, just like a car would. All right, so initial impressions. Absolutely amazing view from every part of the tractor all the way around. You know, your thickest obstructions are here at the columns for the rollover protection system. At least that's my hunch, but very small interference up in each corner. On the back side, you even have a good window to look down to the three-point hitch and see what's going down below. Great access down here too to see on each side of the tractor. Your typical obstruction up front where the loader is, where the right now the bale spear is at, or where your bucket or your grapple would be. Really not a lot you can do about that. You are sitting up fairly high, so it's not terrible. It's a decent line of sight, but you're gonna struggle to see what's going on right in front of the engine. Now, one of the things I am still up in the air about is gonna be the console right here with all of your air vents for your heat and your air conditioning. Haven't used them with heat yet. I'm a little concerned how that visibility is gonna work, how long I need for this tractor to warm up to get the condensate, the frost, whatever else it is off the glass when it's cold out. In the summertime, when we used this same kind of a setup on the M7060, it had, again, the vents and everything right here around the steering column. The air conditioning worked great. That wasn't an issue at all. So it's the heat that's still to be determined. I am used to, just for contrast, the vents and everything being around up top here on the John Deere tractors that I have, which you can rotate them around and face them towards the glass, or face them towards you, or towards the windshield, or whatever you want to. So it's a bit of a different setup, but that does, I think, help with roominess overall, for especially for taller guys, and visibility too. As far as feel, overall layout, everything like you would expect is within arm's reach, right? So you have plenty of space in here. I don't feel cramped at all. I'm 6'3", a little over 200 pounds. Going on a diet, but everything's pretty comfortable, right? You got your tilt steering here too, so you can get that steering wheel right down where you want to. This is not an air ride seat, but it is nice and cushy, comfortable, has armrests. Feels just soft, like you can sit in here for a long time, unlike some of the seats that are out there. You're gonna have most of your controls within reach of your right hand, so you're gonna have your loader joystick. You have your range for fast or slow. This is a clutchless transmission, so there's a little push button on here. You just push that in on the go, and you can change 1 through 6 gears, okay? Forward and reverse is controlled by a slap handle or a lever that's on the steering column itself, so that's very easy and accessible. You can do two things at once. Have your parking brake, a couple of hydraulic controls for that 4th and 5th function we talked about earlier. And then you'll see your throttle control, which you have a hand throttle as well as a foot throttle down below, which again is typical of this design, along with your 3-point draft controls. And of course your PTO. To my knowledge, this is equipped with an E540 PTO, which is an Econopy 540, which allows you to still run 540 RPMs on the rear PTO while operating at a lower engine RPM. And there's actually even more bells and whistles too. You have your electronic 4-wheel drive engagement, just a little flip button there. I don't know what this next button is, to be honest with you. Somebody will tell me. I could look in the manual. I haven't got that far yet. An A and a B and a plus and a minus. I don't know. We'll figure that one out. Working our way up the column here as well, you're gonna have a few extra knockouts, but also some switches for light controls and flashers, it looks like, up top. Your HVAC controls, you know, for heat and AC and the fan, along with a pretty nice Pioneer radio. You're also gonna have your dome light control, some other push button switch with a red light. Not sure what that's about. You got a visor and a sunroof, which you can close off if you want to. I like that a lot. All right, so look around behind me here. You're gonna have some storage, not deep storage, not a ton of storage, but enough right there in a tray. Cup holder with a little more storage down below. If I flip around to the other side, another cup holder, a little bit more storage. Gonna have a 12 volt convenience outlet, and there's your lever, that yellow handle for the EPTO. So really, it's got everything you would expect and then some. It's a very nice cab overall. We're just getting started with the Kubota M4. Again, these are just first impressions. I'm sharing what I know right now. We'll learn more as we go, but I wanna get to using this machine. So we're gonna hook up the land plane, just do a little bit of work with it right now. It's gonna be a green attachment with an orange tractor. You have to get used to that, because there's gonna be a bit of it going on right now until we transition. But hey, I wanna thank you for taking time out of your day to stop by. If you did enjoy the video, give us a thumbs up, leave a comment down below if you have something to add. Subscribe to see more tractor videos. And if you want something for your tractor, for the front end loader or the 3-point hitch, make sure you check out goodworkstractors.com. Until next time, stay safe. We'll see you soon.